Good morning, my dear children. How are you all? I hope you all fine. So I'm very happy to meet you through YouTube class after this monthly assessment. So before the monthly assessment, we have just seen introduction about role of government in health. That means in civics chapter 2. We just have seen introduction. So we are going to continue that in this video. Okay, dear children, this is very, very, very interesting lesson. Okay, dear children, so listen carefully. So let's start this lesson. Okay, in the previous video, we have seen two types of health services. One is public health service and the other one is private health services. Okay, so first we are going to see about public health services. Public health services. So from what is public health service? So public health service is a chain of health centers and hospitals run by government. So public health services are done by whom? Government, our government. Okay, dear children, so it is a chain of health centers and hospitals run by the government. Public health service is a chain of health centers and hospitals run by the government. Okay, dear children, so it has many health centers and hospitals that are run and owned by government. They are linked together so that they cover both rural and urban areas. Okay, these hospitals are linked together so they cover both rural and urban areas. So what is rural? Village areas, and urban, city areas. Okay, together that are linked. So what I told children, village level there are health centers. Okay, there will be small health center. In that who will be there? Nurse and health worker. Okay, they both will be there. Okay, so these nurse and health worker, they are trained to treat common illnesses. Okay, and they work under supervision of doctors at primary health center. Okay, dear children, such a center covers many village areas. Okay, so like a primary health center will be there, doctors, everyone will be here. Okay, dear children, and under this doctors, who will be working? Nurses and health workers. They will be trained to treat common illness. Okay, dear children, so have you heard that term Aramba Sugadhara Nilayam? Yes, you have heard, right? So that is called as primary health center. Next, at the district level there is a district hospital that supervises all the health centers in that district. Okay, like for our district, which is our district? Kanyakumari. Which is our district? Kanyakumari district. So in our district we have one district hospital, that is Asaripallam Hospital. Okay, so in that hospital, what they will do? They will also supervise other health centers, other hospitals in, that means other health centers. We'll have small health centers that work under this hospital. Then large cities have many government hospitals and also specialized government hospital. If it is law in village areas, we'll have like this. If it is a city, what will have? We have many government hospitals and also specialized government hospital, well equipped government hospital. Okay, dear children, the next, why the health service is called public? Because we have many reasons. The government hospital have established health centers for everyone. That means government has established hospitals and health centers for everyone. It is not like only rich people have to come, only poor people have to come. It's not like that. Everyone can come to government hospitals. Okay, the next, the medical facilities are provided at low cost so that the poor can also seek treatment. So it's like all the medical facilities we have in government hospitals are given at low cost. Okay, very, very, very low price. So what happened? The poor can also seek treatment, because since it is low cost, poor people can also go and get treatment from government hospitals. Next, the function of public health service is to take action to prevent the spread of diseases such as TB, malaria, jaundice, cholera, diarrhea, chikungunya, etc. So like some diseases or like spreading diseases, right, that used to spread over many places. Okay, so this function of public health service is to take action to prevent the spread of diseases. Okay, now one disease is spreading like anything. What is that disease? What is that, children? Corona. Okay, so corona is spreading all over India. So who is taking step to control that? Our government, right? So our government has given some measures like lockdown. Then after that, wearing mask. Then so many measures our government has taken. Yes, dear children, it's trying to control the spread of disease. Okay, so what is the function of public health service? To take action to prevent or control the spread of diseases. Okay, dear children. The next, the government must safeguard the right of life of every person. The government must safeguard the right of life. What, children? Right of life of every person. According to our constitution, it is a primary duty of the government. Whose duty, children? Our government's primary duty is to ensure the welfare of the people and provide health care facilities to all. To ensure the welfare of the people and provide health care facilities to every citizen of India. Okay, dear children, the next, what is the next one? Private health services. So private health facilities, this is a wide range of private health facilities that exist in our country. There are hospitals, nursing homes that are privately owned. So this is not owned by government. This is taken and controlled under private organizations or private people. Okay, patients have to pay a lot of money for every service that they use. So in private hospital, they have to pay a lot of money to get treatment, not like government hospital. Okay, dear children, so these are the two healthcare services we have. One is public healthcare service that is undertaken by government, and next one is private healthcare service that is not undertaken by government. It is taken under the control of private people. Okay, dear children, so that's all. Thank you, my dear children. Thank you for listening very carefully. So this is very interesting lesson. So today we just have covered what is public health care service and what is private. Just that topic we have covered. So thank you for listening, my dear children. So just go through this topic. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.